Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Science Thursday. Today we're gonna take a look at the future of cars or electric cars. So let's dive right into it. So why is there a need for such a thing? Well, these are the few components. There are many other components, but these are the few core components. First is a desire to reduce pollution and emissions. So you don't want, you know, toxic gases around you. And if the engine is burning properly, there should not be any black soot coming out of it. But generally, no engine is 100% efficient. Starting and stopping, which you have to do hundreds of times in a city, suffice to say, it's quite polluting. So we don't want to have that. And concerns about increasing oil prices. Now, oil prices have never been going down. Now, the reason why sometimes we appear to have, you know, price drop in oil is generally because we discover a new method of, you know, exploring it out of the ground, like fracking recently dropped oil prices. However, overall, if you continue the trend, it's always getting more and more expensive. And even when fracking allows us to exploit more oil, it will sooner or later run out. So the cost will always keep going up. So there is a very good and strong motivation about the finances. And we wanted something simpler, more efficient than internal combustion engine. That technology has been going on for more than 100 years. So suffice to say, it's a time for an upgrade. So how does it work? As you can see, this block diagram, it's quite simple. You have battery, you have controller, and you have motor. No more components are needed than that. And the first electric car, like practical electric car, was built in 1895. These cars came before Ford T model, although not by decades. These came only 5 years before Ford figured out how to make a mass production of petrol cars. And suffice to say, it's quite simple. Like if you have the chassis, all you need is battery, controller, and motors. So let's look into each components of it. First component, the battery. This is the heart of an electric car. This is the fuel tank. So we generally use lithium ion batteries. Why? Well, as of now, we only have lithium as our best energy density. Basically, per kilogram, it carries the most amount of kilowatt. So watt per gram is quite high in lithium. Lead acid is very low. Nickel cadmium, while being good, it's not as good as lithium. That's why we use lithium in our mobile phones. So capacity of your car's fuel tank basically is measured in kilowatt hour. So you will generally hear things like 10 kilowatt hour battery, 20 kilowatt hour battery, 30 kilowatt hour battery. So these are the capacity of your battery packs. However, be mindful, even if your motor is like 300 kilowatt, it's only taking that for a few seconds, because if it takes that amount of energy continuously, your battery is going to be drained in a few minutes, not like, you know, hours. So suffice to say, be mindful of that. And it all requires, because there are so many cells, individual cells, as you can see in this diagram, this Tesla battery pack, there are so many individual cells that it requires balancing. Without balancing, the damaged cell will damage the entire pack. So we employ something very complicated known as battery management system. This actually does increase the cost of the system, and if you have good battery management, your battery pack will last longer. So it's not that you can ignore it. If you want to make your battery packs last longer, given the fact that it's the most expensive component, you will invest in battery management system. Then we come to thermal systems like cooling and heating. Cooling you specifically need if you are drawing or putting in a large amount of current. Like if you are speed charging, you need cooling. If you are driving it in hot weather where you are not driving at full speed, it's gonna need cooling. So although cooling has been not present in every electric car, but like Nissan Leaf comes to the mind, and that's kind of important, especially if you want to make sure your things run long. Then we come to the ports that we need, as you can see in this. Now this is one hindrance for electric cars, as it is not standardized. So there is no standard for it. Like some people go for DC to DC charging, some people go for high voltage AC charging, some go for high voltage DC charging. Basically, as of now, there is no absolute standard that every car manufacturer will follow. This makes a speed charging network kind of impossible because of this limitation. And this one important point that I want you guys to pay attention to is that bigger battery will not give you more range. Now you will be like, okay, that does not make any sense. Well, one simple way to understand is, let's say this battery pack is 30 kilowatt. You want to make a 60 kilowatt. You will just double it. Okay, you doubled it. Here's the deal. The weight went up. Now, kilowatt consumption per kilometer is also gone up. That's why, like, if you see a battery pack that is like 10 kilowatt goes up to 150, 200, to increase that, to give it to 200, you just don't double it. You have to triple the amount of battery you need, because kilowatt per kilometer is also going down. This is very crucial for electric cars. This is the reason why we just don't put giant amount of battery, because it's basically carrying its own self, and battery do not get lighter as it's getting discharged, unlike petrol or diesel or anything that carries its own fuel. Fuel is burnt and gets lighter. It's very crucial for aircrafts, and that's how they maintain their maximum profit. They never fill the jet with full fuel, only 60-70%. Of course, if they're going cross continent, they're gonna need it, but you get the idea. Bigger battery will not always increase your capacity or range. Then we come to motors. Now, there have been a lot of ideas how to we approach this, and best as of now is AC motors, like either synchronous motor or induction motor. Induction motor is the as of now used in Tesla motors, as you can see, and they are generally controlled by what's called VFT, basically variable frequency drive. It's quite common technology, so nothing fancy. And the reason why we don't have a lot of BLDC cars is very simple. BLDC requires not only permanent magnet, which itself is ludicrously expensive, it loses power over time. Your motor will not give the same amount of power after 10 years, specifically if you are in a hot environment. Second, a BLDC motor requires a very specific sort of position information. So your inverter, which is providing the power, needs to know where the rotor is. Suffice to say, it's ludicrously more complex. And induction motor has been going on for like 10, 20 years, 30 years, continuously running. We can manage that. So it's as of now, AC motors are king. And I highly doubt that it's ever gonna change. So all things considered, what do we have as of now? We have very good range. Now you can buy a car which has 100 kilometers to 500 kilometers very easily. And we have quick charging. Not every car supports quick charging, but we can easily get quick charging from 5 minutes to 30 minutes. Basically like 0 to 80% of your full charge. And good speed. Like earlier cars were very slow. They were barely able to go to 60 kilometers per hour. Now we have cars that can match a supercar. So suffice to say, we got it. Speed got it. Low cost of operation. Now this is very crucial. Like let's say you bought something which cost you more than your petrol car, you're not gonna buy it. It cost very low amount of money per kilometer. Like instead of spending your dollars on petrol, you're spending your dollar for electricity. So it has to be cheaper, which it is. And the best accelerations are possible in electric car. There is no competition about it. Like a dragster, which have like 5,000 horsepower, obviously they will outcompete it. But normal car to car, day to day use, your electric car will outperform almost any internal combustion engine if you set it to. Because generally they don't want you to use that. It degrades the battery. So they are like, okay, just chill. You can do it, but they will not advise it. And then you have very high reliability, since there are only three components, motor of which is like quite reliable, inverter even if it breaks it's just a small component that you can change, and battery have no moving parts. So only moving part being a motor, you have quite high reliability. There is no timing chain, there is no valves clogging up, there is no spark plug that's not working. Like simplicity equals reliability. And we have no pollutants, like there is no tailpipe, there is nothing coming out of it, like there is no soot, there is no nitrogen oxides that are harmful, specifically with diesel engines. So all those things considered, it's also quiet. Like imagine if you have electric cars in a traffic jam, hundreds of electric cars jammed in a traffic, it's quiet. Now if there is an internal combustion engine, you're gonna go mad. So suffice to say, we have quite a large list of achievements with electric cars. So with all that, what is the problem? first of all, like, it's supposed to be cheaper, but it's more expensive. As of now, there is no comparison between the cost of a electric car versus a cost of an internal combustion engine, whether it be diesel or petrol. So suffice to say, flat out people right there is like, I'm not trying that. Second, there is not a lot of options. Like, two successful cars as of now, the first successful car is Nissan Leaf, second is Tesla. Now, the reason Tesla is not the first is they have very severe delivery limitations. Like, they are not delivering as quickly as the demand is. So they have a lot of orders, but they haven't delivered a lot. And Nissan Leaf has been constantly being delivered, and as of now they are at least 100,000 unit ahead of Tesla. So that's a very crucial point, that even though there are 10-20 electric cars, you only have availability of 2 to 3, so not a lot of option. And this is the limiting factor, is that battery life is not in decades. Like, you're supposed to buy a car, not everybody is going to buy a car and like, okay, I'm gonna change my car in 1 year or 2 years. People want their car to last. Even if they have intention to change it, they don't want it to like, okay, we used it for 1 to 2 years and now it's done. It's not a smartphone. This is, as of now, core limiting factor of cars. Not the range, this. It's the fact that your car will not last long. Like, your batteries can be need to be replaced as early as 5 years or maximum 10 to 20 years. So 10 years is ultra maximum. So suffice to say, this is a very severe limitation that is inherent to batteries as of now. And last but not the least, like, even with all this, it should be, you know, mass adopted, is our psychology. Now, what we have is called range anxiety. Basically, we are used to the idea that if you fill your tank of gas and you're gonna go like 500-600 kilometers. Here's the deal, this anxiety is kind of pseudo anxiety, because most people, including taxis, barely exceed 100 kilometers a day, barely. And Japan sort of realized that, and they actually made their entire taxi fleet in a city electric, and it was very successful. And the reason for that is, like, we just think, like, because we like numbers, like, you know, 500 kilometers, 1,000 kilometers, are you really gonna drive that long? Like, and people say, okay, what if I want to go on long drive? Either you can rent another car, which will be more practical, given the fact that there is no way you're gonna buy a SUV for your daily use. It's inefficient. You'll buy a normal city car that is good for city, and if you're going for a long trip, rent a sedan or rent something that is more comfortable. So suffice to say, this is a psychological block, and we think of electric cars same way as we think of petrol cars. Like, you know, we're gonna go somewhere and we're gonna fuel it up. That's not the right way of thinking of it. The correct way is, like, when you come into your home, in your garage, you plug it in, you sleep overnight, you remove the plug, you go. There is not supposed to be like, you know, okay, I'm gonna recharge in 5 minutes, I'm gonna recharge in 1 minute. So you don't need to. Like, you can charge it anywhere, your office, and where are you gonna go where there is no electricity? So suffice to say, our psychology is a kind of a big hurdle as of now. So this may change over time, especially if we cross that 1000 kilometer mark. So this was my presentation on electric cars. I hope you guys liked it or learned from it. In that case, please like, or if you didn't, dislike, leave a comment, and please subscribe, because I make video every day, and press the bell icon to be notified. And as always, thanks for watching.